Extraction of Neville and Crown. Electricity surges have been spotted. Use caution in responding.
I'll check it out.
Another one done.
Are you shitting me? Get it right!
It makes it easier when the bad guys show up for you.
No, you don't have to fight, right? They want to get hit. Is it over already?
Plaza. Officers, we have reports of suspicious behavior.
All night. Somebody's asked for special treatment. I got moves for all of you.
Get back!
Get back in the fight!
now! Get off! Get off!
Getting a bit more! Really?
Stop slacking and get back out there!
I will put you on this!
Still got all your guns?
Get up! Some serious hurt!
It's over. You're safe.
Got here just in time.
Anytime, officer.
No way!
What? That's the one.
They're in the hospital.
Your punches.
The Court of Owls is watching. From inside of Gotham's walls, they lurk in every shadow. And they rule you, one and all.
You knew. All along you knew, and you never told Bruce about the threat to Gotham.
When I was still part of the League, we observed the court's growth in Gotham. Now you can see the city's rotten core.
They're mining something. Something that seems like it might come from a Lazarus pit.
A foul substitute for the true miracle. A contaminated extract. For centuries, the court has been looking for a fountain of youth. Instead, they found the makings of undying monsters.
Guess we know how the Talons are cooked up, then. Thanks for that. But why leave the court digging? Why not offer them a Lazarus pit? Then control them from the inside.
Even in their current debased state, the League would never descend to such banality. And the court's greed and corruption prevent them from ever mastering the secrets of the Lazarus Pits.
You don't treat the Lazarus Pits any different than the court.
Oh, those are some harsh words. After all, your friend Jason benefited.
What about what he wanted? Jason had no say in what you did to him.
I suppose gratitude was too much to expect in exchange for another stab at life.
You don't get to talk about gratitude right now, Talia.
With Bruce gone, the court's operation grows. The League of Shadows will raise Gotham to the ground unless you silence the court.
I know you, Talia. You just want us to get rid of the voice so you can do whatever you want. What's your endgame here?
I'll do what I can to distract the League. And your path to the Court of Owls will be clear.
Oh, this is how Montoya feels.
Hey, Alfred, did the city records turn up anything?
They didn't. According to the city permits, there's been no mining in Gotham City since the cauldron was completed.
Judging from what we found last night, they've been digging down there for centuries.
Give this a listen, Alfred. Babs managed to repair some of the court voice recordings.
Dionysium brought the Talons back to life.
Sort of. Dionysium's basically weak as hell Lazarus pit water. Brings back motor functions, but free will's as good as gone.
So what is a Talon exactly? Some kind of feral zombie assassin?
We've all seen weirder shit. Maybe.
Feral zombie. Sounds like Jason, all right.
I recognize a voice. The older woman is Constance Cobblepot, I'm fairly certain.
And the others?
More difficult to say. Maybe if I heard them in person.
In person? Tim, put the waveforms on the screen.
It's hard to find a match with all the damage and voice modulation. Maybe the matching system would have better luck if...
We match what we have against the live voices.
Fun, but how do we find these jackasses?
Two words. Orchard Hotel.
The Masquerade. The event of the season. This year's dedicated to Master Bruce.
Gotham's rich dress up and pretend they're humanitarians. I've been a few times.
So it's Dirtbag Central.
With so many of Gotham's elite together, security at the Masquerade will be tight. Finding out their plans first would give you an important advantage.
I'll tweak our masks to record telescopic audio.
If we can get a good vantage point, we may be able to put some faces to these mystery voices.
Sounds like our kind of party.
Got new intel for the evidence board.
I leveraged a mutual acquaintance. The head of security for the Orchard Hotel, Mr. Hendricks, has agreed to a meeting. The details are pinned to the evidence board.
Physical and mental preparation go hand in hand. Here, we can train the mind to prepare the body, but it requires deep focus. Let go of your self-doubt and focus on my voice. In the heat of battle, remember to not rush. Time your strikes well to build momentum in the fight. You're ready to move on. I'm proud of you, Dick.
Mr. Hendrix.
Thanks for the heads up, Belfry.
Units required near Gate and Grand. Officer requested backup now.
Did you call backup?
We got them on their way.
Out!
You should go low.
That's it then. Gotham City.
Thanks. You got me out of a bad situation.
It's nothing.
Thank you.
You're back. Wonderful.
I've always heard the Orchard Hotel is haunted.
Not only is the court real, but so are Talons.
I thought they'd be more, I don't know, intelligent? They're supposed to be the court's greatest weapon.
It's more difficult to control someone capable of free will.
Or anyone able to think at all.
But that doesn't mean we can underestimate them. They are still capable fighters.
Sure. I just won't try to have a conversation with them.
The court must have been...
Who's faster than a speeding bullet now?
Number 1 for 10.
like Court grabbed Hendrix.
We have reports of gang activity.
With luck, that's Hendrix.
We need officers near the Gotham Naval Research Facility.
Easier when the bad guys show up for you.
Nightwing decided to pay us a visit. This won't have a well time. You should run.
I had a feeling this day was coming. You wouldn't believe the things that I heard at the hotel.
Probably why the court wanted you silenced.
Shit, they're real? That explains the masks. Look, one of my guys was feeding them info. You know what? You should probably have all the same intel too.
Thanks for the drive. We'll take care of it from here.
This city is going to the birds, I swear.
Belfry, I dealt with the court. Got a data drive for the trouble.
Excellent. Please return to the Belfry so we can evaluate next steps.
Seconds away from the scene, dispatch.
It's not safe here.
What was that?
Better take a look! Hey, it's Nightwing!
I've uploaded the data we got from Hendrix. It should be ready soon. I've seen Bruce make that same face when he got stuck on a case. What's on your mind?
Everything starts with Ra's al Ghul attacking Batman, but I can't figure out how it connects.
You've never had to fight the League, have you? Ra's was a fanatic. He formed the League of Shadows centuries ago to root out corruption all over the world.
His philosophy, if you want to call it that, is that he should destroy things to build them back up. He's wiped out multiple cities over the centuries.
He set his sights on Gotham. Batman stopped him. He was impressed. So he named Bruce his heir.
That suddenly, even though Bruce said no thanks.
But it meant Ra's left Gotham alone. That is until he showed up and... Bruce.
Talia says Ra's was behaving erratically when he died.
Yeah, I put money on that not being the whole story.
Hang on. What if our starting point is earlier? Batman died while he was investigating the Court of Owls.
You think Ra's found out about it? But why come after his heir?
Ra's cares about two things. Rooting out corruption and protecting the Lazarus Pits. So if the court was using an extract from the pits to create talents...
Ra's blows a gasket, steps in himself. Things escalate, both he and Bruce end up dead.
And without Batman keeping a lid on Gotham's corruption, the court starts to stretch its wings.
The League follows Ra's to Gotham, and there's nobody to stop them from attacking the court.
Gotham City becomes ground zero for a goddamn war.
And no Batman to save it.
I guess that's our job now.
Yeah. It is. And we know what we need to do. We root out the court. And we keep the League away from Gotham.
I really miss him.
Excellent. The drive Mr. Hendrix provided us contains exactly what we need. I've set up a safe house for Mr. Hendrix. His original one was compromised, but he'll be all right now.
Glad to hear it.
Modulator is going to be a pain to remove. I'll pull up some of Bruce's old files, see how he disguised his voice back in the day.